want. Remember, you can interact with us right here on social media. Keep the hashtag, that is Easy Friday, at KBC Channel 1 on Twitter, at Shiksha Arora underscore on Twitter. Tell us where you're watching from. Our sign language interpreter is Byron Abuli. Now, tonight on Primetime, we'll be talking about what exactly the situation is in the Aberdares, as more than 40,000 acres has gone down in forest, that is in ashes. And of course, we'll also be having a look at what the situation is in the north of Kenya, as there have been efforts to secure it from the bandits, that is in the north of Kenya. Now, that and much more. But for now, it is time for the highlights. I am an innocent man, Pokot South MP David Poseng defends himself after being drilled by DCI over banditry in the north. Aberdare on fire, more than 40,000 acres of forest in ashes. And the conflict in DRC. President Ruto rallies the Democratic Republic of Congo's leadership to drive stability in the country. And tonight, the top story. Pokot South Member of Parliament David Poseng has maintained his innocence following allegations of involvement in aiding banditry activities. Poseng, who was grilled by detectives on Thursday and Friday, termed his woos as political witch hunt. He also distanced himself from the white helicopter that is said to be used to ferry firearms.
After spending the better part of Thursday night and Friday being grilled at the Directorate of Criminal Investigations headquarters along Kiambu Road, Pokot South Member of Parliament David Kosing was finally let go as investigations continue. Kosing maintaining his innocence, saying that he was never in any way involved in banditry activities or linked with livestock trade.
He has never sold cattle. He has never dealt with livestock. So those are new issues. He has never received any proceeds from the banditry that is in that region.
Is politics your weevil? Even if you buy a shoe in West Pokot, right? It will be propaganda to say, where did you get that shoe, and so on and so forth.
Kosing saying that his wars were politically motivated and that the alleged white chopper used to ferry firearms did not belong to him.
I don't have a white chopper. Mine is white and green. And this white chopper, Wameongea yake from even before, about 3-4 years. Yeah. So, mwende mutafute hii white chopper huko, mali sijui huko, mimi sijui huko.
He also blamed authorities for arresting him to cover up for the alleged killing of 200 cows in Pokot.
The owners of the cows were arrested, were brought to Kitale to prefer charges. And as a leader of Pokot, when I helped them to be released, it became an issue, and that is why I'm here. I said, oh, why did Kosing help people to pay even Kwanini alilipia our bond, Kwanini Kosing is associated with the cattle rustling, I'm a benefiting.
Police officers are set to conduct further investigations of the lawmaker's chopper at Wilson Airport on Saturday. The lawmaker has maintained his commitment to preaching peace at a time when the government has embarked on an operation to flush out bandits in the North Rift.
In fact, I lead the most peaceful constituency in the whole country. I lead the most peaceful. Number two, I have never recorded a police statement since I was born. I have never been in police. This is my first time.
After 2 days of grilling, Pokot South Member of Parliament has maintained his innocence, even as the government continues with the joint operation to restore peace in the volatile parts of the country. Nancy Okware, reporting for Easy Friday from the Directorate of Criminal Investigations.
Meanwhile, security operations to flush out bandits in the troubled northern parts of Kenya kicked off today after a 3-day ultimatum amnesty for anyone in possession of illegal firearms to surrender elapsed yesterday. Now, the operation by the military is set to stabilize the region that has been the hub of bandits terrorizing residents. Take a look.
It's now down to business. A convoy of military vehicles and the Kenya Defence Forces officers fully armed make their way into parts of Baringo County in efforts to rescue residents from the cost and attacks, deaths and theft of livestock by bandits. The move coming after the lapse of the 3 days amnesty period accorded to residents to surrender illegal firearms. The entry of the military into the rescue effort is, according to the government, set to bring to an end. Bandits have been terrorizing locals in the banditry-prone areas of Baringo and never heeded to the government call to surrender the firearms. The recurring attacks have forced the government to usher in joint efforts of police and the Kenya Defence Forces to flush them out of their hideouts. The operation rekindling hope for residents and victims to live in their homelands in peace, as many have lost their lives and property while others are fleeing for safety.
Serikali ifanye operesheni ili watoto wetu waweze kwenda shuleni vizuri, kwa sababu matumaini ili tuko nayo saizi kama wazazi, kama wakahazi wa Kenya ama kama wakahazi wa Kapedo, hatuna wanyama, hatuna chochote, hatuna nini, lakini ile kitu tunatumaini saidi kwamba ingeweza kutusaidia ni elimu, ambayo mashambulizi haya ya kila siku yamesambaratisha.
Security iko, lakini Pokot ataka kujua yeye ni kama hata anashinda Al-Shabaab. Yeye anapiga mtoto, akipata hata mtoto kwa, hata kwa mbuzi anapiga risasi. Hata tukua uwanja kama hii ya mpira, nasitukia anagonga mtu huko, nagongi kwa mbele, anagongea nyuma. Ukikaa hata mbele, ukisimama hivi, unashindwa risasi inatoka wapi.
In Kapedo, a region that has been battlefield for decades, the locals are hopeful for a bright future as the operation begins, saying they have suffered at the hands of merciless bandits. This happens even as the family of the late Philip Oipa, who was killed by bandits in Lomelo 10 days ago, prepares for his burial, with the family hoping that this will be the last burial they will conduct as a result of banditry. They are urging the government to end insecurity in the region.
Wanapenda kukua na watu, lakini wanaua watu karibu. Na wanaona watu, ni wanaua mtu ambaye hata hana bunduki, hata mshale, hata mkuki, na watu hivyo.
For Easy Friday, I'm Gladys Mungai.
Now, two Kenya Wildlife Service officers have died while fighting fires in Aberdare's forest. The fast-spreading fire, which is still raging in the forest, has left more than 40,000 acres of Aberdare forest destroyed since its onset in the last week.
The wildfires that were reported on Monday, February 6th in the Aberdare moorlands have left two KWS officers dead.
Jumanne tarehe saba walipokuwa wanaaga, walikuwa wanaenda kwa moto. Hawa ni watu wamejitolea nguvu zao, hali na mali, kuhakikisha kwamba mbuga inabaki inatulia. Kwa hivyo familia tunawafariji.
While addressing the media at the Aberdare Forest, the KWS Assistant Director of Mountain Conservation, Bakari Mungumi, said they have been working day and night to try and keep the fire out, which is spreading very fast.
But nonetheless, we have some positivity. We have a zone of other tree species like the Hagenia. Hagenia, popularly known as the rosewood. This is also a species that stops the fire. So whenever the fire goes to the Hagenia, it stops. Whenever the fire goes to the heather, we are in trouble. So this is the challenge that we have. We have positives and we have negatives.
With the help of KFS, Nyeri County, Nyandarua County, Kenya Pipeline and Rhino Arc, they have deployed more than 200 personnel who are fighting the fire.
We are doing our level best. The teams that have been mobilized, we've asked for more support, and I'm sure by end of day we should deploy more people here and ensure maybe tomorrow or the day after we'll be through with this fire.
Fast spreading fire is still raging the Aberdare National Park, with more than 40,000 acres destroyed so far. Ruth Wamboi for Easy Friday.
Now, President William Ruto has called for political leadership in the Democratic Republic of the Congo to drive stability in the country. He says the effort must be corroborated by countries neighboring DRC for peace and sustainability. The president spoke in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia on Friday during the African Union Peace and Security mini-summit of heads of state and government on the situation in the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo.
President William Ruto says without bold steps, the region will not be able to ride the negative effects of instability in the Democratic Republic of Congo. He said the resolution of the conflict has a long way to go and appealed for more support from regional bodies and the international community. He noted that resources will support comprehensive interventions to assist the growing humanitarian needs. Kenya is actively engaged in talks to end the conflict in DRC and has sent envoys and military assistance to protect civilians in the eastern part of the vast country. During the meeting, President Ruto strongly urged the convening of the Nairobi 4 session of the Inter-Congolese Consultations. Joan Njunge for Prime Edition.
Now, the Azimio La Umoja leaders Raila Odinga now wants the government to engage in consultations with all stakeholders in reconstituting the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission. Speaking at a rally in Kisii, Raila said his push for electoral and economic reforms was unstoppable. Azimio leader Raila Odinga says he won't relent in pushing the Kenya Kwanza administration to bring down the cost of living and drop what he termed as punitive taxation.
The Azimio leader led his team to Kisii as he sought to rally support for his push for electoral reforms and the bringing down of the cost of living. While maintaining his claim that his victory in the last elections was stolen, Raila says his push for electoral reforms was focused and wants government to make the reconstitution of the electoral body IEBC consultative.
Tulimalizana na mahakama, sasa tuko mbele ya mahakama yenye nguvu zaidi, mahakama ya wananchi. Na tuko mbele yenu na ushahidi mpya. Whistleblower akaonyesha vile ziliibiwa na tuko na idadi ya kura za baba. Si amemwelezea.
He says Kenyans continue to bear the weight of ballooned cost of basic commodities and can therefore not afford what he termed as punitive taxation.
Tunashaka kuona kama gharama yale ya maisha yote inarudi chini. Pili sisi tumesema ati wizi ikianza hakuna mwisho yake. Maona wale ambao walikuwa wameshtakiwa na serikali juu ya mambo ya wizi wanaofunguliwa. Kesi na kesi inachukuliwa. Kenya is not just another country. Kenya is a nation ambayo sisi tumepigania. Mimi nitasema Buffalo Soldier kwa sababu hawezekani kabisa tuache nchi iharibike.
Raila further faulted the Wednesday evening purported raid on former Interior Minister Fred Matiang'i's home, accusing the Kenya Kwanza administration of what he claimed is weaponizing government institutions.
Kama kuna kitu natupata kwa Bwana Matiang'i, niambie Bwana Matiang'i watu wenu wanakuja. You should give a notice. But don't treat Bwana Matiang'i as a criminal in Kenya.
The pressure rallies head to Kisumu on Saturday before an interdenominational prayer service at the Jivanji Gardens next week. John Jacob Curia, Easy Friday.
And with that, it's time for us to get into the first commercial break for tonight. We'll be back in just a moment. Don't go too far. This is Easy Friday.
Milioni mbili kila siku kwenye M-Pesa. Chagua lipa na M-Pesa Paybill number 757070. Account number andika neno loto. Kisha weka star na nambari yako ya simu. Weka kiwango chochote cha pesa kuanzia shilingi 50 hadi 2000.
Aulali.
Lipa kisha subiri draw.
Welala. Nitakutimizia ndoto zako. Milioni 2 usiamini.
Jumbe huu umeidhinishwa na BCLB.
So you two talk, huh?
Well, I was
Don't just even explain to me, Tina.
Worried. Wewe na nani?
Trish, mwenye runei glass ndani, ikivunjika utafutwa kazi.
She's graveling and screaming in beauty.
Trish, usifall kwa trap yake. Akotuna maneno mingi, kizungu mingi 1 million account iko empty.
Agreed. Ulisoma divorce papers?
Mimi, sita saini hizo karatasi za divorce.
Mama Jane! Wacha! Mama Jane! Mama Jane, mimi!
Jumapili hii kwenye runinga ya KBC, ungana naye Askofu Michael Wanderi wa kanisa la Christian Foundation Fellowship Kiambu kuanzia saa 1 hadi saa 2 asubuhi.
Ningetaka nikwambie our Jehovah God, because the Bible says he is the same yesterday, today and forevermore. He is able to take you to a place of abundance. He is able to take you to Rehoboth in the name of Jesus Christ.
Kipindi ni neno la neema, ukiletewa naye Askofu Michael Wanderi wa kanisa la Christian Foundation Fellowship Kiambu. Usikose.
After the conclusion of an impressive Athletics Kenya Cross Country Championships, Team Kenya now sets her sight on the 44th edition of the Global Showpiece, the World Athletics Cross Country Championships, Bathurst 23 in Australia. Lined up for the titles is Kenya's contingent of 30 world beaters, ready to contest with more than 550 athletes from over 60 nations. Enjoy these spectacular races from Bathurst, Australia on Saturday, 18th February 2023, live and exclusive on KBC Channel 1. KBC Channel 1, your true sports partner.
Do you have a new story to share with KBC? Get in touch swiftly on email news@kbc.co.ke or call 0723-892-654 or 0734-780-124.
Welcome back. Now, the County Pension Association has moved to the Supreme Court to challenge the decision of the Court of Appeal that allowed the implementation of the National Social Security Fund Act 2013. The association has termed the judgment made on 3rd of February 2023 unconstitutional. This and more from the courts.
The Supreme Court is expected to have the final say on whether the upward review of contributions to the National Social Security Fund should stand. The County Pension Association argues that the decision by the appellate court to give a nod to the amendment goes against the spirit of the Constitution. The association, in petitioning the apex court, said the act undermines the orderly function of the pensions industry in Kenya. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court has struck out a petition filed by Jimmy Wanjigi against former IBC chairman Wafula Chebukati on the matter of qualifications and nomination of candidates to vie for public office. Wanjigi was denied clearance for lacking sufficient supporters as required under the law for failing to submit a degree and that he did not submit his running mate's nomination certificate.
Now, netizens have a nose for hot and juicy stories, and each time there is one, it quickly becomes literally an instant celebrity online. You definitely don't want to choma picha because the savage netizens will devour you before you can explain, for they are always ready to pounce. Let's dive in and sample this week's trending topics while it's still hot.
Today, I'm here to remind you of a very well-known phrase. Whatever goes up must come down. So let's find out what transpired this week.
We begin with the analogy of an elephant on a tree and how it eventually came down. Arsenal Football Club, a team that was on top of the table. Underline was, because that is definitely past the tense. Arsenal had been topping the table since August, with their ever-noisy Gunners fans denying the netizens some peace. But the awaited big fall finally came, and oh boy, this had to be a trendy topic online, with keyboard warriors training guns to the Gunners after they lost a game to Manchester City. Ryan wrote, Arsenal being at the top of the table is like the elephant being at the top of the tree. You are not sure how it got there, but it was bound to fall. Kennedy Wandera tweeted, hey, we are on top of the table, and other short stories. It's gone. B sarcastically used Arsenal fans' words, ati it's lonely at the top. Omondi, mara ho, sisi ndio tuko on top. Mara ho, tulipiga Manu. Mbona sahi mnalalamika, eti hiyo game ilikuwa OPEC surely?
We cannot take ownership of the results that is going to be announced because of the OPEC nature which these results have been handled.
Ali with Savagery Blaze tweeted, I love seeing Arsenal fans cry. It is my daily fun, weekly joy, monthly inspiration, and yearly motivation. Jeffe highlighting a funny video. Vile ka team kametolewa top of the table. Webby tweeted, it seems the title has become slippery for the Gunners. They have really tried to get hold of it, but it seems the title is sliding. Well, the title will definitely slip from the Gunners if their goalkeeper Ramsdale continues to pull this kind of stunt of flying around instead of catching the balls.
Salam alaikum. Alaikum assalam.
Anyway, let's fly into the next sizzling hot topic the way Ramsdale just did. Bomet County Women Representative Lynette Toto made it to the top of trendy topics this week after getting proposed to on Valentine's Day. Now, what got netizens' heads turning was the fact that Toto had a close man friend who helped her during the campaigns, and they are feeling betrayed on his behalf. Wilfred quoted an excerpt from the Caucasian Chalk Circle that says, the valet initially belonged to the goat keepers, but it was given to the fruit growers because they had good plans for it. Well, tafakari ya babu. Jahome, unbelievably, this gender.
My people, for this life, after God, try to fear women.
Lucy wrote, why is she not crying? To which Carol responded, she crowed before. We, dunia ina mambo, and you guys continue to fully amaze every day.
The ting goes grrr, skinny keeper.
Well, that's it for us. Catch you next week on Savage Netizens. For Easy Friday, I am Teresa Mutai.
All right, and of course, that was on the light-hearted side of Easy Friday. Now, let's look into culture. Considered the oldest and best-preserved Swahili settlement in East Africa, the Lamu Old Town is characterized by the simplicity of its structural form, enriched by such features such as inner courtyards, verandas, and elaborately carved wooden doors. Every year, a cultural festival happens here to celebrate the rich Swahili culture. And tonight, in our weekly segment, My Culture, Michael Mwandiga tells us how the most recent cultural event went down in the coastal county of Lamu.
The beautiful Lamu Island. Lamu Old Town is a unique heritage with more than 700 years of continuous settlement and was declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Over 40,000 foreign and domestic tourists were enthralled with door races, donkey races, display of handicrafts, fishing competition, among other electrifying activities and performances. The annual event was cancelled in 2020 and 2021 due to coronavirus restrictions, and this year, like earlier before, it showcased the rich culture and heritage of the Swahili people.
Especially kwa watali. Lakini sasa imekuwa ni mtanganyiko, hata waswahili pia wananunua hiki kitu. Na kisha tunawafundisha na watoto wetu, lao si tumeondoka, basi na wale watoto wetu nao watapata kuendelea na huu tabaduni wetu. Na kuna vitu tofauti tofauti hapa, kuna mashua, kuna masiwa, kuna marufaa, naona kuna bao games, kuna macho, kuna zisanduku.
Wazee wetu walikuwa wakishona kwa mikono hizi, lakini kisha baadaye kulikuja kampuni ya Korea na China na Japani, wanashona kwa mashini. Sisi tulikataza mashini, tuliweza kunyoa kipawa cha kushona kwa mikono. Utamaduni wa wazee wetu wa Kenya Red Sea, wanamshika shark kilo 400-500 konchego wa kushonesha mikono.
The festival features Swahili poetry, traditional dances, henna paintings, door races, swimming competition and donkey races, as well as Swahili bridal ceremony, among other activities that are aimed at promoting the unique Swahili culture. Other annual festivals celebrated in Lamu include the Maulid Islamic Festival, Lamu Yoga Festival, Lamu Painters Festival, Lamu Art Festival, the Shella Hat Contest and Fishing Competition, among others that attract visitors in droves. The theme organized by the county government of Lamu was a melting pot of diversity and multiculturalism. Stakeholders described it a huge success. Lamu Governor Issa Timami contends that many festivals held in the island will offer tourists the opportunity to explore the archipelago and discover what makes Lamu tick. The county boss added his administration was impressed with the many foreign tourists thronging the island despite the travel alerts issued by a section of European countries.
Tuna mikakati ya kurudisha tena kisiwa cha Lamu kama kisiwa cha sherehe. Kuna sherehe aina nyingi. Tutakuwa na sherehe ya kofia kule Shela. Alafu tuna pia sherehe ya kuchora. Kwa hivyo lengo letu ni kuhakikisha kila miezi miwili kuna sherehe ambayo itakuwa ni kivutio kwa watalii na Wakenya wengine kuja Lamu.
He says the celebrated Swahili culture heritage is a unique wealth of Lamu which must be preserved so that it can provide economic benefits to the island. Lamu Tourist Association Chairman Ghalib Al-Awi says the cultural festival is one of the most anticipated events that provide a wonderful opportunity to experience the island's pristine beaches, medieval ambience, magnificent old stone town and age-old traditions of enchanted island where history continues to live.
Yanza 2001 culture tukiwa sisi kutoka 80s miaka ya 1985, 86 na 87, tulikuwa mbele sana ya Zanzibar na Zanzibar walikuwa nyuma yetu mbali. Nasikitika kwa kuwa leo Zanzibar imekuwa mbele yetu Lamu kwa kiwango kikubwa sana. So kwa hivyo Governor Timami na serikali yake ikishirikiana na serikali kuu kukuza utalii, na tunapata watalii wa hapa ndani nchini na wale wanaotoka bara la Ulaya, bara la America, bara la Australia.
The hotelier says the festival draws such huge crowds that it becomes nearly impossible to find accommodation in Lamu Old Town. The 20th annual Lamu Cultural Festivals gave visitors a chance to learn about the unique, distinct Swahili dialect of the island dwellers, which include Kiamu, Pate, and Kisiyu. Kiamu is the common dialect used across the islands in the vast Lamu County.
Kupotea kwa lahaja ya Kiamu kwamba hakizungumzi sana. Na uzungumza wengi sana ni wazee ambao ukiangalia katika historia, watu ambao wameshikilia hii lahaja. Sasa watoto wanapoinukia hivi sasa, generation ya sasa, wameacha yani ile asili yao. Sasa wakifika maeneo mengine sasa inalizungumzwa yani lahaja ambayo ni broken, yani lahaja ya Kishengi. Sasa huwa ni upesi sana kushika lahaja nyingine.
Nafikiri ndo kinazungumzwa na watu wengi kwa sababu ndo kisiwa ambacho kina idadi kubwa ya watu, na ni tofauti kabisa na ile standard Swahili ambayo tunaifahamu, ambayo ni lahaja ya Kiunguja. Nafikiri baada ya miaka mingi watu kisha wamefanya fikra kwamba kuna lahaja nyingine ni duni, lakini sivyo. Ni kwamba wakati walipoanza kutaka kuchukua Kiswahili kama lugha ya kufanya biashara ama lugha ya kutumika katika mambo ya kiofisi rasmi, kama lugha rasmi, ilikuwa inabidi wachukue lahaja moja ambao ingeweza kurahisisha kazi hiyo.
It was so curious, so I collect my friends to arrive here to looking what is going on, because the cultures is so important for the whatever in the world. It's important. We are from Europe, we are so different from the culture from here, but this is still the future, it's not the past, because people want to see these things.
This year's spectacle featured a whole lot of quality performances. Michael Mondiga for My Culture.
Right now, taking a look at matters business, doctors have backed the commercialization of GMO food in Kenya, noting that no health issue has been found in relation to consumption of GMOs. Kenya Medical Practitioners and Dentists Union Deputy Secretary Miskela Dennis is urging the government to increase funding for research, especially on issues concerning GMOs.
That some of the things they have developed, their research and data to back it up, that there's no correlation with issues around cancer, issues around immune reactions and allergies and all that. So I can authoritatively say from our discussion that some of those issues that have been peddled around are lies.
In fact, we are going to even throw out a challenge to NACOSTI to even support this multidisciplinary team to invest in this research, either if you're doing a longitudinal study or we're doing a retrospective study to actually look for those correlations and associations. But the fact still remains, the concerns of Kenyans are legit, the concerns of Kenyans are acknowledged, and the doctors have heard them.
Evidence available, scientific evidence available, which is part of what we were showing today, is that there is no single safety concern about BT products or crops. There are only a few concerns being raised in social dimensions, such as farm rights and the rest, but which have adequately been addressed by the Safety Act that we have.
State of Kenya's economy is set to improve in the next 2 years on the backdrop of a falling inflation rate, projected favorable weather conditions, and easing inflation. Old Mutual Investment Quarter 1 2023 Outlook says the government should deepen investment in agriculture and infrastructure to jumpstart economic growth.
Speaking during the inaugural Old Mutual Investments Group Quarter 1 2023 investment discussion, Old Mutual Investments Group Kenya Chief Investment Officer Eric Karimi said, despite inflation appearing to stabilize at 9%, it may remain elevated in the near term because of high oil prices and poor weather conditions which are affecting food prices. Karimi says due to the continued weakening of the Kenya shilling against the US dollar, rising interest rates and inflationary pressures, the current state of the economy reveals growing fatigue and enhanced risk with the traditional asset classes such as listed equities and bonds.
Unless something there is done to stop it, which is unlikely in the near term, then there's going to be a shortage of supply. So just last week, Russia announced that they're going to cut its daily production of oil by around 500,000 barrels, I think.
Irrespective of the challenging economic environment, findings from the outlook shows that spreading one's risk by investing in a well-diversified investment portfolio made up of both growth and income assets and securities is key for better and stable returns.
Things might be a bit shaky on the economy side, but there's always new industries coming up. There's always sectors that are going to benefit whether the economy is up or down. And those are the sectors in which we want to play. Things like agriculture, infrastructure.
According to Kevin Nyaga, head of alternative investment at Old Mutual Investment Group, the current investment portfolio of traditional asset classes such as cash and near cash, stocks and bonds to include other alternative assets or securities, use returns and performance have a lower correlation with the traditional investment markets. Andrew Kero for East Friday in Nairobi.
Meanwhile, let's focus on the capital. Nairobi County has the potential to double its revenue generation if it improves the business environment and accessibility to infrastructure. The Kenya Institute for Public Policy Research and Analysis, KIPRA Chair Benson Ateng, says easing licensing and permit processes could increase revenue collection to meet financial obligations.
Nairobi County's population has grown fivefold since the 70s, making it among Africa's fastest growing cities. However, development of the metropolis has not been at par with this, leading to a congested city. The Kenya Institute for Public Policy Research and Analysis, KIPRA, says to ensure the capital city develops sustainably, Nairobi County must improve accessibility within the city, improve the business environment, as well as governance.
Nurturing emerging sectors, including the creative economy, by enhancing access to affordable and appropriate financial capital, will support growth of firms and creation of decent jobs.
The report indicates that even though Nairobi generates about 40% of its revenue, this could be improved significantly.
This is a concern, and which is also affecting even our competitiveness. So countries like Rwanda, I know they take even less than a day to do this connection. So I think this is a lesson that we need to pick from other countries, and that's why maybe perhaps these businesses are also preferring to go to the other countries. So
the report also indicates that the most alarming shortfalls of Nairobi County is youth unemployment, as well as unnecessary hurdles for businesses seeking to start operations, occasioned by delays in accessing electricity to about 8 to 7 days.
It's part of what makes for a greater environment, the ambience of a city. And that's what makes people want to come to that city. But at the end of the day, it's opportunities. Can I find productive jobs? That's the key.
The report recommends that Nairobi County automates business registration and payments, revamps the road network, leverages urban planning tools, and develops a land index to compensate compulsory land acquisition. Hibak Said for Easy Friday.
Now, Stima Sacco has reported a surplus of 4.17 billion shillings, up 1%, which was dragged by an increase in insurance premiums and a higher loan loss provisioning. Stima Sacco CEO Gameleli Hassan has backed the government's decision to integrate SACCOs into the national payment system to enable them transact in forex, clear checks, and directly lend to one another. Take a look.
Timasako's asset base in 2022 grew by 16% to 53.7 billion shillings, while the loan book grew by 12% to 41.3 billion shillings. Revenue went up 9% to 7.4 billion shillings, driven by investment income and growth in interest income from members. Despite this, the SACCO's surplus was flat, growing just 1%.
This year it's a bit down, and it's not as grown as we would love to grow, and basically for two reasons. Number one is what I've talked about, the heavy provision that we have had to make, which is just provision and insurance. And number three is that we also felt that we needed to give a little bit more to our members.
The SACCO hopes that innovative solutions, member-centric financial products, and tapping the Hustler Fund will drive its growth this year.
We see ourselves still on a growth trajectory. We will hold on to the key items that we had put in the plan, which include growth of membership, which include products and services that are friendly to the improving needs of the members.
He says reforms such as creation of a central liquidity facility and SACCOs joining the national payment system would grow revenue streams.
Our running call around that is we do appreciate the discussion around the NPS. We do appreciate the discussion around the shared platform, the SACCO shared platform, and we hope that Stima SACCO will actually be the first SACCO to be connected once that comes in.
Stima SACCO say it will pay dividends at the rate of 15% and 11% on interest rebates on the share capital. Wairi Mujenga for Easy Friday.
Now, the effects of the ongoing drought situation are worsening for the fisher folk, with water levels in rivers that feed their fish ponds drying up. Now, here is Nduta Mukami with all the details.
The impact of drought on food and nutrition security has been devastating, already affecting more than 4 million people. Signs of crop failure or poor harvests have prompted leaders to appeal for relief for food to save lives. There has been an increase in cases of fish dying due to changing weather patterns, and some farmers have had suspended operations to await the onset of rains.
Bereni, watu wakua wanapanda miti. Na forest wataungana pamoja watu waanze kupanda miti. Ndio sasa mito yetu iwe na maji ya kutosha. Iyo ingine, watafunza watu vile watakuwa na tengeneza wakueko kwa iyo visima vile wataweza kuweka samaki. Kwa hiyo naona hakuna mambo kama hiyo itafanyika.
The slump in fish production from local ponds coupled by severe pollution in water bodies is impacting aquatic life.
There is so much pollution, and when there's so much pollution, even the production of fisheries, even the issues we are talking about, how do we even make our people from bottom up in relation with also matters of developing themselves in the small issues they do in businesses, it will still affect them.
Consequently, they said that a parliamentary caucus on climate change, conservation, and waste management would be formed to implement remedies.
We have also formed a parliamentary caucus on climate change, issues of waste management, and the matters of conservation.
Nduta Mukami for Easy Friday.
Andika neno loto kisha weka star na nambari yako ya simu weka kiwango chochote cha pesa kuanzia shilingi 50 hadi 2000
au lali
lipa kisha subiri draw
we lala nitakutimizia ndoto zako milioni 2 usiamini.
Jumbe huu umeidhinishwa na BCLB.
Enjoy a selection of the best Regina Ray and Tingazi.
Bado jamwambia unamlike mrieleza jamwachilia mkono kutoka nikuje hapa.
Love blossoms in Mexico with the Trier sisters in Las Bandidas.
I beg you, please don't go.
Want you to be the happiest man in the world with a woman who appreciates and respects you.
An array of music rave.
Make me love you.
knuckle jams. And we sit a chat with the Dhiambo.
You know, I can't even tell whether you're looking at me, you seeing me.
The Louis Vuitton.
Classic comedy.
Nakono too.
Mashabiki.
Not again.
What? Enjoy the Diva's programming this February only on KBC Channel 1. Kenya's watching.
So you two talk, huh?
Well, I was
don't
just
even explain to me, Tina.
Worried. Wewe na nani?
Trish, mwenye runa glass ndani, ikivunjika utafutwa kazi.
She's graveling and screaming in beauty.
Trish, usifall kwa trap yake. Akotuna maneno mingi, kizungu mingi, 1 million account iko empty.
Agreed. Ulisoma divorce papers?
Mimi, sita saini hizo karatasi za divorce.
Mama Jane! Wacha! Mama Jane! Mama Jane! Mimi!
After the conclusion of an impressive Athletics Kenya Cross Country Championships, Team Kenya now sets her sight on the 44th edition of the Global Showpiece, the World Athletics Cross Country Championships, Bathurst 23 in Australia. Lined up for the titles is Kenya's contingent of 30 world beaters, ready to contest with more than 550 athletes from over 60 nations. Enjoy these spectacular races from Bathurst, Australia on Saturday, 18th February 2023, live and exclusive on KBC Channel 1. KBC Channel 1, your true sports partner.
Biggest odds in the world every day on selected matches. Make a decision. Mozart Bet.
All right, welcome back to Easy Friday. Now it's time to get to know what's happening in the world of sports. And of course, we've got our expert in studio. Her name is Karen Kibet, as she gives you the lowdown on what exactly is going on. Now, Karen, the World Cross Country happening in Australia. What's going on? What are we expecting? Do we expect some big wins?
Oh, yes, we are definitely expecting fireworks when five events take place tomorrow, the main event being the 10-kilometer senior men, where we will be having Geoffrey Komoror from Kenya, Joshua Cheptegei from Uganda, Solomon Barega from Ethiopia. So it'll be fireworks because that particular race has all the winners of the last three editions. So it'll be fireworks and it'll be broadcasted live on KBC Channel 1 as from 7:30 a.m. all through to 11 or 12 there.
All right, Karen, over to you.
Thank you so much, Shiksha, for keeping us up to speed with matters, all that is happening in the country. Let's now take a look at what's making headlines. And we begin with the World Cross Country, where the world steeplechase record holder Beatrice Chepkoech will lead Kenya's medal quest in the mixed relay, which will kick off the World Athletics Cross Country Championships on Saturday in Bathurst, Australia. KBC Channel 1 will broadcast live the World Athletics Cross Country Championships from Bathurst, Australia, starting from 7:30 a.m. Preparations are in top gear ahead of the annual Mount Kenya Mountain Running Championship, slated for the 26th of this month in Buri, Meru County. Mount Kenya Mountain Running was established in the year 2020 and is held annually in the month of February.
According to Meru County Governor Bishop Kawira Mwangaza, the mountain run will play an integral role in cancer awareness and boost tourism in the county.
That I have called you here today to support the county government to one supporting mountain run, creating cancer awareness, promoting environmental conservation, and this event presents a good opportunity to exercise your corporate social responsibility through contributing to this noble cause of addressing pressing issues in our community.
Our sentiments were echoed by the secretary of the organizing committee, Vincent Mutwiri, who revealed that the run will be divided into different categories, urging more corporate bodies to register in big numbers.
Some will wonder, why are we not calling it mountain run? Why are we calling it mountain running? It's because it's supposed to be like an adventure, not just like a normal run you've done in the field from here you finish. This is a competition, climbing the hills, going down the valleys, passing through the plains. It's like an adventure.
Mount Kenya Mountain Running was established in the year 2020 and is held annually in the month of February.
70% of Meru County is semi-arid and adversely affected by the raging drought. This situation can be remedied if we join hands towards addressing the challenges.
2020 national champion Patrick Kipngeno and Sheila Jebiwot were crowned champions in the 2022 Mount Kenya Mountain Running Championship. For Easy Friday Sports, I'm Daniel Mwendwa.
Thank you, Dan, for that report. Moving on, former league champions Kenya Police men's hockey team lost 3-1 to Nigeria's Police Machine in the ongoing Mozzartbet Africa Cup of Club Championship hockey tournament at the City Park Hockey Stadium. Meanwhile, another Kenyan side, Western Jaguars, lost 1-0 to Egypt's Zamalek.
Police Machines scored the opener in the 23rd minute through Sandy Godwin after laxity from the Kenya Police defense line. Emmanuel Sandy added the second goal for Nigeria outfit in the 47th minute. Kenya Police pulled one back in the 55th minute through Samuel Ounko before clinical finish from Emmanuel Sandy that ensured Police Machine bag maximum point. In another match, reigning Kenya champion Strathmore University women's hockey team lost 2-1 to Nigeria Delta Queens, while Kenyan side Western Jaguars lost 1-0 to Egypt's Zamalek. Strathmore University women, Kisumu Lakers, Blazers, Butali Warriors and Kenya Police are representing Kenya in the Continental Showpiece. This year's edition of Africa Cup of Club Championship will climax on Sunday after 1 week of play. King Orimwangi for Channel One Sports.
Thank you, King Ori, for that report. The Kenya Golf Union is set to hold the inaugural University Golf Day this Sunday at Vetlab Sports Club. The event has been organized to have an engagement with the university and college students who are key in the transformation of the game of golf in the country. To get the universities to adopt golf as a sport, establish university golf clubs and develop university golf leagues where frequent competitions will be held. Over 150 students from 17 universities and colleges have registered. 60 students will play in a tournament where individual prizes will be awarded and the best performing university recognized.
We are looking at this as an opportunity for continuity for our pathway player, for the player pathway, right from the junior golf, elite golf, throughout college. Our objective is to get universities to adopt eventually this golf as a sport also in their curriculum.
Tertiary institutions like colleges are also going to have representation during the tournament. And this is just the first of a series of tournaments which shall eventually, hopefully, be coordinated by the universities themselves.
Manchester United coach Erik ten Hag has hailed his side after a thrilling first leg 2-2 draw against Spanish giants Barcelona in their Europa League playoff tie at Camp Nou. Meanwhile, Italian side Juventus played a 1-1 draw with Nantes, while Monaco secured a 3-2 win over Bayern Leverkusen.
United seemed to take control of the first half, missing open chances to force a goalless half-time score. In the second half, servicemen grabbed the opener through Marcus Alonso before United responded 2 minutes later.
every day on selected matches. Make a decision. Mozart bet.
To get Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 as your skiza tune, dial *811*967#.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not in your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6.
To get Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, dial *811*967#. *811*967#.
She wanted a good wedding. And of course, as a man, that's the only thing you can promise to someone you want to marry anyway. I spent a lot of money until immediately after the event, I realized I had nothing.
Do not budget other people's money. Do not budget. Lower your budget. If you have to lower the number of guests to be able to work with what you have in your hands, what you can bring out.
We made sure we operated within what we had. People, when they thought we had gone for the animal, actually we went for a prayer mountain to pray.
Thank you for keeping it easy Friday. Those are all the sports stories we had for you tonight. But do not forget that tomorrow, as from 7:30 a.m., KBC Channel 1, your true sports partner, will be airing live the 44th edition of the World Cross Country Championship live from Australia. 453 athletes from 48 nations will be competing in 5 events, with a major event which we are all waiting for being the 10-kilometer senior men, where Geoffrey Kamerol will battle it out with the defending champion Joshua Cheptegei. Do not miss that action live on KBC Channel 1. My name is Karen Kibet. Do have yourself a peaceful night. I hand you back to my colleague, Shiksha Arora. Shiksha.
Thank you very much, Karen, for that. And of course, as Karen said, tomorrow, make sure you're tuned in, because you're going to get to know what's happening. The World Cross Country here live only on KBC Channel 1. It's time for me to say goodnight to you, but don't go too far, because on the other side, we've got Cole Jacks, who's going to be bringing to you all the vibes that you need for Friday. Remember, disco funk coming up. But for now, great music, entertainment is on the way. And do stay tuned, because he will be bringing that Friday fever in full swing. It's time for me to say bye-bye to you, as I said. And of course, not forgetting the sign language interpreter tonight, who has been Byron Aburi. Good night. See you next week. Cole Jacks, over to you.